Good evening everyone and welcome to our webinar on Moong Futures. My name is Zubi Sheikh and I thank you all for joining in for today's webinar. During this webinar, we will discuss about Moong Futures contract, and to talk about this topic, we have Mr. Prasoon Mathur with us who will take you to this entire session. But before we begin this webinar, would like to share some details about how you can interact with us today. As an attendee of the webinar, you will be in listen and view only mode. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask them in Q&A option, which is available on your screen. We will take a session at the end of this webinar and try to address all your questions. So now Prasoon will take over this session. Prasoon, over to you, please.
Thank you, Zubi, and good evening to all of you. As we all know that Moong Futures was launched for trading at exchange platform on 8th July 2019. Currently, 6 contracts are available for trading, that is from September 2019 till February 2020. Liquidity is gradually improving in this commodity. So in pulse basket, the market participants now have 2 products, that is chana and moong. Chana is a rabi season crop while moong is primarily a kharif season crop. Pulses are among most important commodities from trading point of view, as they have seen ample price volatility in the past few years due to various reasons. Since moong is comparatively a new product for market participants, the current interaction session aims to provide more exposure about various aspects of this product, which in turn will help market participants in making an informed trading decision. So, with this background, the current presentation focuses on number 1, importance of moong, number 2, its contract specifications at NCDEX, its crop cycle, the supply dynamics of moong, price and arrival performance of moong, and finally, crop management and important diseases. So we will discuss one by one all of these. Now let us briefly discuss the importance of moong. Moong is an excellent source of high quality protein. Moong is consumed as whole grains, sprouted form, as well as dal in variety of ways in our homes. Moong is also used as a green manuring crop. Moong can be used as a feed for the cattle. In India, these crops are cultivated in 3 different seasons, that is Kharif, Rabi, and Summer. Summer moong can be grown after harvesting of pea, gram, potato, mustard, and linseed. Now, we will discuss in detail the contract specifications of moong, because knowledge about contract specifications is very important so that market participants can better understand this product. Moisture cannot be more than 10%, so 10% is the maximum limit of moisture content. The foreign matter cannot be more than 2% by weight, of which maximum 0.5% by weight may be the inorganic matter and impurities of animal origin. The other edible grains can be maximum of 1%. Damaged seeds should be maxed up to 3%. Immature, shrunken, shriveled, broken, split seeds should also be maximum 2%. Vivid seed should be maximum 1%. Small seeds, that is the seeds which will pass through 3 millimeter long sieve, if these small seeds are there in the deposits, then their percentage should not be more than 2%. Discolored seeds other than dark green seeds should not be more than 2%. Seeds with loss of luster, they should also not be more than 5%. Cauli seed, they should be less than 0.5%. So we will discuss all these parameters in detail in our next few slides. The material should be free from live infestation and fungus as per the FSSAI standards. The trading unit and delivery unit of Moong is 5 metric ton. The trading symbol is MOONG, Moong. The delivery logic is compulsory. The position limits for member are 50,000 metric ton and for client is 5,000 metric ton. The basis center for Moong is Mehta City in Rajasthan. There are 3 additional delivery centers, Jodhpur, Nokha, Sri Ganganagar, and recently Exchange has also added Nagaur as an additional ADC, and it will be effective from February 2020. There is no premium discount for Jodhpur location, while Nokha and Sri Ganganagar are at 50 rupees per quintal discount from the Mehta City. I would like to drag your attention towards the pictures shown in this slide. So the first picture shows a sample of the moong. You can see that majority of the seeds are of green color. However, different color seeds are also there. There are broken seeds as well. There might be some immature seeds. So all the categories of seeds we will describe in our from slide number 2 to 8. One can easily distinguish small seeds comparative to the seeds available in the moong sample. So these seeds are less than 3 millimeter size. So a deposit having small seeds less than, you can see the small seeds less than, the quantity of small seeds should be less than 2%. Similarly, one can observe the damaged seeds. Picture number 4 shows immature, shriveled and broken seeds. Their quantity should not be more than 2%. Picture number 5 shows discolored seed. One can easily observe that the color of the seed is mostly brown or black. However, the lot should have maximum green seeds. Picture number 6 shows loss of luster. That is the seeds which have lost their shine. There might be 2 color in a single seed. So one can easily recognize such kind of seeds. Cauli seed. If you break a seed into 2 parts, you will observe white color inside the seed, that is cotyledon part. So the quantity of such seed should not be more than 0.5%. Picture number 8 shows vivid seed. Isko hum Hindi mein kehte hain ghuna hua dana. To is tarike ke seeds ki matra bhi 1% se zyada nahi honi chahiye. Now we will discuss some important points about these parameters in our further slides. Let us talk something about moisture. In Moong, moisture varies from 14% to 10%. At the time of fresh crop arrival, fresh crop will start arriving from September last to October. So the moisture is higher, that is around 13 to 14%, and it starts reducing later on. At the moisture level of 10 to 11%, the moong can be kept up to 2 years. If moisture is high, there might be fungus attack resulting into rotting of the produce, and there may be weight loss in later stages, and there might be possibility of color loss as well. Fumigation is also required every 3 months in moong. Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh moong usually has higher moisture than Rajasthan moong. This is the trader feedback. Price discounting for moisture, that is, for every 1% moisture rise, the price is reduced by 1%. This is also trader's feedback. So all these things one must know about the moisture parameter. Now we talk about the foreign matter. In mandis, there is no scientific method to check it, and traders do it by visual assessment. Moong with minimal foreign matter and green color is called polished quality, and it fetches higher prices. In case of mechanized harvesting, the quantity of inorganic matter, that is gravel, sand and dust, etc., is usually higher than the organic matter. Now we talk about the other edible seeds. There is possibility of presence of both guar, chola, urd, soyabean, etc., that is all the kharif crops in the moong mandi arrivals. It is to be noted that moong fetches higher MSP, highest MSP, as well as higher market prices vis-a-vis other pulses. So any other kharif pulse or other material which is lower in prices can be mixed with it. One must be vigilant in about the maximum limit of these parameters mixing in the moong deposits. Now, all the seeds which are discolored, immature and shriveled comes under this broad category. During threshing, there is probability of damaged seeds. The quantity of damaged seed increases in the mechanical threshing. And weevilled grains, presence of weevilled grains depends upon the maintenance done by the warehouse service provided during storage. Moong requires fumigation every after third month to avoid this problem, and the gunny bag must not be torn. There are few interesting observations that might be helpful for market participants. As per trade observations, the moong size of Ganganagar belt is bold. However, from processing point of view, the Melta city moong is preferred. Moong produced from irrigated regions. Many of you might be knowing that Ganganagar belt is irrigated. Most of the area in Ganganagar belt is irrigated. So the moong produced from irrigated regions has a white mark in the portion below the outer thin coat of moong grain, which absorb more edible oil while preparing moong snacks. इसको हमने अभी कौड़ी सीड आप लोगों को बताया था. सो सच मूंग हैज हायर टेंडेंसी ऑफ स्प्लिटिंग ड्यू टू हायर मॉइस्चर. गोइंग टू हायर मॉइस्चर, द अपर कोट ऑफ मूंग इज इजीली रिमूव्ड. नाउ वी टॉक अबाउट द कैरी फॉरवर्ड स्टॉक. एज पर रफ एस्टिमेट, अराउंड 60 टू 65% ऑफ द टोटल प्रोडक्शन इज कंज्यूम्ड एवरी ईयर, and around 25% of the total production is carried forward. Rest is exported or used for seed purpose. So moong is exported as well as imported both. Now we will study the moong crop cycle. Myanmar is a major producer of Moong. The Moong is produced during November and December. January and February is the peak harvesting period in Myanmar or Burma. In India, Moong is produced in three seasons: Kharif, Rabi and Summer. Kharif season sowing period is July and August. Harvesting takes place during September and October. Rabi Moong is sown during October and November time period and harvested during January and February. Summer Moong in different states is sown during January, February or March, April period. Accordingly, harvesting starts in March, April or May, June. Basically, three irrigations or rainfall at the gap of 15 days are required to grow Moong. So if I talk about the important growing states, so top producing state is Rajasthan. The major sowing period is July and August, and harvesting takes place in September and October. Like in Madhya Pradesh, Moong is sown in Kharif as well as spring or summer season. That is, sowing takes place during February to April, and peak arrivals come in May and June. In southern states like Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, Moong is produced in Kharif, Rabi as well as summer season. That is, in all three seasons, Moong is grown. Now, we will discuss the Moong supply dynamics at macro level. One can see that from 2010-11 to 2018-9, there has been a rise in Moong production, and the production has increased substantially during past 3 years compared to 15-16, 14-15 and 13-14. The share of Kharif Moong is much higher than the Rabi Moong. So 70% of Moong is produced during Kharif season and around 30% of Moong is produced during Rabi season. If we talk about the share of Moong in total pulse area and production, then one can observe that the line, orange line, shows the share of Moong in total pulse production. The share of Moong in total pulse production is around 8-10%. However, the bar diagram shows the share of Moong in the total pulse area. So Moong share in total pulse area is around 12-14%. Now we study the major producing states and their share. Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana state. These six states jointly contribute for around 73% of the total Moong production of India. And Rajasthan alone contribute around 37% in India's production, followed by Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Karnataka. If we talk about Kharif Moong production, then again Rajasthan has a lion's share in Kharif production. 52% of India's production comes from Rajasthan, followed by Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka. So these four states contribute around 82% of India's Kharif production. While Rabi Moong production, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar and Andhra Pradesh, these three states contribute for around 56% production. And Madhya Pradesh and Bihar are two important states. Apart from Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, these are also important states from Rabi Moong production point of view. So market prices will largely discount Rajasthan crop scenario during Kharif season, while in Rabi season, it is expected that market will be guided by the mainly from the Madhya Pradesh and southern part of the India crop situation. Now, we look at the import scenario of moong into India. We can see that the overall pulse imports was around 55 to 65 lakh ton during 15-16 to 17-18 period. However, due to bumper pulse production, the import of all pulses declined during financial year 18-19. And during FY 19-20, the pulse import is also likely to remain low. Among all pulses, the highest share is of peas, followed by chana and tur. Moong share is least in India's pulse import. One can see that during financial year 18-19, the moong share in total pulse import was hardly 3%, while urd proportion was 19%. Highest import was of pea, followed by tur, masoor and chana. So import prices or import market does not significantly impact India's moong scenario until and unless there is severe crop loss. Now we will have a look at the prices and arrival performance of moong. One can see in the given chart that MSP of moong has seen a consistent rise. The MSP has seen a sharp rise during 17-18 and 18-19, as the government is making an efforts in giving farmers their double income. So moong market prices have remained higher compared to their MSP most of the time. But due to higher production during 16-17 and 17-18, all pulse prices including moong started falling, and currently moong prices are trading far below their recommended MSP. Now look at the moong mandi arrival trend in key producing states. As we discussed earlier, that key Kharif arrivals are seen in Rajasthan and Maharashtra. Key Rabi summer arrivals are seen in Madhya Pradesh and Karnataka. So in diagram, we can see that during October, November, December, whether it is 2016, 2017 or 2018, the period of October, November, December, in India, highest arrivals were seen in Rajasthan, followed by Karnataka, then Maharashtra. However, in case of Rabi or summer season arrivals, which comes mainly in May, June and July, this is the peak period of Rabi season crop arrival. Madhya Pradesh is the leading state. No other state comes near it. That's why we told you that in Rabi season or in the period of June, July or August, market should watch the arrivals in the Madhya Pradesh, while in October, November, December, Rajasthan will play a crucial role in deciding the market sentiments. Now, more specifically, we will discuss the prices and arrival trend in the Rajasthan, because our moong futures contract is for the basis center of this contract is in Rajasthan, ADCs or also in Rajasthan. So Meta city is our main delivery center. Our ADCs are Jodhpur, Noka, Sri Ganganagar and Nagaur. Chart number one shows the average monthly prices. Chart number two shows average monthly arrival. And this is the trinium average, the average monthly average of past 3 years. So one can observe in chart number two that arrivals were highest during October, November, December. When arrivals were highest in chart number one, we can observe that there is a very narrow price gap among different mandis due to huge arrival pressure. But as arrivals start declining, one can see in chart number two that during March, April, May, June and July, these are the lean arrival periods, and due to this one can observe in chart number one that there is a huge price gap between different mandis. This dotted line, red dotted line, depicts the prices of Meta City. So we can observe that most of the time the Meta City prices remain above from all other mandis. So narrow price range during peak arrival period, and prices become volatile during lean season. Now we come to the next slide. In this slide, we observe the arrival seasonality in Rajasthan mandis. One can observe that approximately 6,000 tons per month arrivals are seen in Meta City. It starts declining from April, May, June and later on. In Jodhpur, the average arrival during peak arrival season are around 3,000 to 2,000 metric ton. In Sri Ganganagar, compared to Meta City and Jodhpur, the arrivals during peak arrival period are far less. Similar situation is in Nagaur. Now, in next slide, this is very important slide, that Moong Mandi arrival and price spread of Meta City to other mandis. In chart number one, the red line shows the price trend in Meta in different months. So one can observe that prices are usually at their lowest point during October and November period, and later on they start improving, and the highest prices are seen during May and June period. Now, on right axis of this diagram is price spread, that is price spread from Meta City versus other mandis. So we can see that Nokha, Jodhpur, Sri Ganganagar are having prices less in range to in minus 5 to 10%, and the negative price spreads increases during April, May, June and August. Similarly, arrival spread, the red line in diagram number two shows the arrival pattern of Moong in Meta City. Highest arrivals are seen in October, November, December, and they start declining towards July, August, September. In other mandis, that is Jodhpur, Sri Ganganagar, Nokha, Nagaur, the arrivals are lower by 25 to 80% in these mandi compared to Meta City. And this is the very reason why Meta City has been made the basis center of Moong. Now, apart from mandi arrival, prices, supply and demand, other important factor is its crop management and important diseases. One should also know little bit about these factors to understand the holistic scenario of Moong. The Moong crop need high temperature, less humidity and moderate rainfall of about 60 to 80 centimeter. Water logging is fatal for root development and nitrogen fixation during early vegetative stage. Water logging in the fields should be avoided at all cost. Crop is generally grown as rain fed, but under assured irrigation condition during summer, it is grown into Indo-Gangetic plain of North India. So, as far as irrigation is concerned, generally moong require one life-saving irrigation, and which can be applied during early pod formation stage. For the summer or spring moong, 3-4 irrigation are required. So irrigation can be given after 20 to 25 days of sowing, and it can be repeated after 10-15 days as per need. Now we talk about the major diseases in moong. Moong crop is very vulnerable to the virus infection. Yellow mosaic virus is an important disease for moong. One can observe the picture given in the right hand side of the slide. And it is transmitted by white fly, and the tender leaves shows yellow mosaic spots which increase with time, leading to complete yellowing. And yellowing leads to less flowering and pod development. Early infection often leads to death of the plant. There is other disease which is called leaf curl, and one can observe the second picture in this slide. There is enlargement of leaf. Later, the leaves become thicker and leathery. And the other disease is anthracnose. There are circular brown sunken spots with dark centers and bright red orange margins on the leaves and pods. Infections just after germination causes seedling blight. Other important disease of this crop is stem fly. Basically, the stem fly maggots mine the leaves or bore into the leaf or tender stem, resulting into withering, dropping and death of the plant. And this disease can cause 5 to 20% damage in moong bean. One other important disease is Bihar hairy caterpillar. This insect totally denuded the crop within few days, resulting into total failure of crops. So Bihar hairy caterpillar is also a disease which can make ample amount of harm to this crop. Other important disease is Cercospora leaf spot. This is also a important fungal disease of moong. Leaf spots are circular and irregular in shape, with brown to grayish white centers and reddish brown to dark brown margins. Such spots are also visible or affected pods become blackened. Insect and pest attack is also there. The loss in the production caused by them may result up to 70% depending upon the severity of the attack. And there is also white fly attack. The infested plants become very weak, showing downward cupping of the leaves, giving a sticky look, and plants may die. Insect secretes honeydew on leaves, results blackening of leaves, drastically reducing photosynthesis rate and drying of leaves. So these were important diseases. One can keep an eye during growing period on these diseases so that one can make assessment about the likely production scenario, and this will definitely affect the market sentiments. So broadly, the presentation is over, and we can start question answer session, if any.
Thank you, Prasun. This was really an interesting presentation. So now, guys, as we have completed the session on Moong futures contract, in case if you have any questions, please put those in the Q&A option on your screen and we'll have Prasun to answer those for you. Fine with this, we have come to an end of this session and would like to thank all our attendees for joining in today. You can always stay updated on more upcoming webinars on our website.